it is accepted that there is a fascist Talib terror operating in our province in this election period. JVP in particular has faced a lot of attacks. Some people have faced gunmen and various houses have been attacked. So they have said that they want to build a wall, popular wall against this terrorism. Now, in facing that, the government ministers have said that what is happening is very similar to what has happened in 89, and therefore JVP cannot complain. What they mean is that in 1989, all of us faced Desaprevi Janata Vyapar, patriotic movement launched by the JVP. They attacked everybody. I was attacked in that election 89. And that was fascist style terror coming from underground organization which is working secretly. Now, the difference is that particular fascist style movement has got into the government. Today, the Desaprevi Janata Vyapare, all components are within the government, including the best part of JVP under Vimal Veeramasa. They have joined the government. Then, Hellurume also there. So, the movement of Dinesh Kumar. These were the component of Desaprevi Janata Vyapare in 1989. Today, it is operating within the government. That is correct. So, it is a very powerful movement now in the country because it has the state power in its hand. How are you going to face this? JVP says, we are going to build a wall, people's wall. What has happened so far? Have they got went into discussion with other parties, other organizations? Did they call a conference? Did they call an assembly of people? Did they created committees in areas to face the fascist terror? No. No discussion, nothing happened in the way. So we warned the JVP that what you say is correct, but we have failed to organize against this fascist type attacks coming from the state. Then, as far as the development is concerned, today the government says they have got support from China. But we believe and we know that the support coming from China is as bad or as good as coming from America. Because China is a global capitalist country, country which is within the global capitalism. It is no longer a socialist society or not even a degenerated workers country. It is working within the parameters of neoliberalism. Out of 500 powerful multinational corporations, 400 or more are operating in China. They have invested. Large part of the investments in China is today belongs to the multinational. Chinese state controls about one-third of the economy. But as a state capitalist organization, not a socialist state, so therefore, the country, we are taking money from capitalist country. It is a country working within the market economy, as accepted by all powerful countries in the world. And we get money, we get support on the basis of paying back with the amount of interest. And therefore, it is forced to believe that Uncle China is coming from abroad and they come and give chocolate to us. And the government says, here we got chocolate, We are reducing the prices of electricity because uncle is there. He has helped us. This is all nonsense. We cannot accept that. China, we are getting indebted to the world capitalism.